Hey, and thank you for clicking play. Now, sorry there hasn't been any videos in the last couple of weeks. Just been busy and haven't really felt like it. And ironically, so last week we had, which is what this video is about, we had the Perth Amiga users group. And I just felt like just relaxing into the event, to be honest. I didn't feel like worrying about if I'd taken video of everything. And I knew other people would be running around taking videos, so that was fantastic. So what I'll do in the description, I'll link to the video. I literally didn't take anything except one photo, which I'll put in situ when the time is relevant. But just to say, it was a fantastic event. So I just want to open this with saying thank you to Matt, Al, Shane and David, the main admins of the Perth Amiga Users Group Facebook group. And I'll put the link to the group as well if you're in Perth. And even if you're anywhere in Australia, join the group. It's a fantastic little community. So I'll put the links to other people's videos, three stand out, and any others that I find I'll put up as well. But one by Vance, and Vance is a great guy. And at the end of Vance's, he's actually got some footage of games that he's made himself in Games Maker, so PC games, but they're Amiga remake games or other retro game remakes. So do take a look at Vance's. There's one by Reese as well. Reese, I've got a heap of computer games off, so he's one of the guys. Most of the games, a lot of the games that I picked up locally in Perth have been from him. Vance is the guy that I actually got the keyboard off. And the other one that I'm just thinking of just now, there may be more links in the description, so just check them all out, or check whichever ones out you feel like, is from Mike. Is the guy that gave me Doom 2 and Descent for PC. So that's great as well. So I really do appreciate the fact that those guys ran around. I know Graham from Commodore Cave, he was there, so he may post up some video. I'm not sure if he was taking any on the night. I think maybe he was doing the same thing I was doing, which was just relaxing and enjoying the event. If you've ever done this kind of thing, you know you just get obsessed with viewing things from the wrong side of the lens. So sometimes you just got to chill. So that's what I did. But what I want to do is, other than the thanks that I've just given, is just tell you a bit about the event. So we had a new venue, a much bigger room than previous years. Fantastic venue. So lots of people. And again, even though we call it the Perth Amiga Users Group, there was things from, I don't know, an Atari. Let's go. The Atari VCS was there, all the way up to, well, Raspberry Pis. Were there as well, mainly because I took one. There were some Windows XP era PCs there doing a link up Quake 3, and that's where I want to get into what was quite amusing about the evening. So I think most of us that had to bring kit all forgot something. I was quite proud of myself because I'd really limited. I thought, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do an emulation corner. And then I ended up selling some kit. Now that's another story that I'll leave for another video. But then it basically came down to, I'm going to take my tablet, which I've taken before, running UAE for all, and I'm going to take the Raspberry Pi. Okay, so easy. Pretty much most of my stuff fit in a backpack. What did I forget to take for the Pi? A screen might help. So there's the Pi. I taken it in the box, everything with the mouse, the power. I hadn't taken the flipping screen, which was great, because what it meant was there was a projector at the front of the room, so I hijacked the projector for as long as I could, and we just had Amiga demos running off that. So that was that was a fix for the solution. And of course, because everybody's got retro kit, I'm going around the room going, did you bring a screen with HDMI? And everybody's going, oh, HDMI, no, because of course they're all old screens because it's all retro, and I'm running around looking for one with HDMI. Oh dear. Well, I found it funny anyway. Shane, that I took a lift down with, a few things last minute, and he forgot the keyboards for the machines that were doing Network Quake 3. Several people forgot things. I can't remember it all now in the heat of the moment, but it was quite hilarious. But look, it all came good in the end. So that was great. We had another raffle, which is great. And each time they're taking the money from the last raffle to put back into the following raffle. So the first prize was actually an Amiga 500. I didn't win that. I put up second prize. So my iMac, my Tupperware iMac, I put that up as second prize and somebody won that. So that's good. And there was a Casio watch as third prize. I didn't win any of them. I was thinking, if I'm going to win anything, I'm going to win the iMac back. But even that didn't happen. I couldn't even win my own machine back, which would be cool. I'd have passed it on to the next draw anyway, because, yeah, that's the whole idea of donating that. So that's great that they're doing that. I didn't win the quiz either. Do you know what? A couple of people pulled out of the quiz because they got the highest marks, but they always get the highest marks. And I knew from the scoring that I'd actually done quite well in the quiz. So I was thinking, I'm in with a chance here. I might win something with the quiz. And then Matt, who's the main organizer, flipped it and said, this time we're going to give the prizes away to the lowest scores. And I think I can't even win the booby prize. Like, what the heck is going on? It's all in good fun. It's great. And that's what it's about. There's great food. So Dave, I want to mention David Fowler. He runs... So if you're in Australia, and especially if you're in Perth, but you're in anywhere from Australia, and on my next pickups video, there'll be more information on this. But he runs a website called RetroKit. I'll put a link in the description. And he's one of the guys running the, helping run the group. And he organized, he had stuff there to sell. So sorry, what RetroKit is, I need to do a separate video on this. Again, no affiliation, I just know the guy's a nice guy. But it's hard to get stuff here in Australia. It's hard to get retro stuff. And most stuff is made in Europe or America. And if you buy something, you've got the postage to add on. So he's putting in his own money, you know, out of his this is how he's doing it. He's self-funding this and slowly trying to build it up over time. He's buying in some of that really useful retro kit, hence the name Retro Kit, not just for Amiga, but other stuff as well. And then so that we've got somewhere local to buy stuff from. And that is fantastic that that initiative is being done out of Perth. That is absolutely stunning. Why am I mentioning David Fowler? Not just because of RetroKit, but because, and I've really got to thank you, David, for doing this. And you know why. He organized an interview. So the projector at the front, even though I'd hijacked it for my Raspberry Pi, they then took it back off me, plugged the laptop, and we had a live link up with David Pleasance. So David Pleasance, of course, the who used to do the sales and marketing for Commodore UK and tried to take over Commodore Europe, at least in the dying days of Commodore, and would have done a much better job than SCOM. That's another story, and one that he was happy to share with us. So several of us got to ask questions to David Pleasance, and I couldn't help. I may have had the information leaked to me just as I was leaving the house. And because I had the information leaked, I grabbed my Batman pack box. I wasn't going to take it. So I was able to wave it up in front of the webcam and just thank him personally. And I do thank you, David Pleasance, if you ever happen to watch this video, but I'm sure you won't. And this is the only photo I've got of the night. Not of me. Nobody's got a photo of me asking my question, but there's a photo of that I've taken of David Pleasance on the screen there that you should be seeing now. But I got to thank him for the childhood memories that the Batman pack brings, and then ask a question basically for the group to hear the response to, which is, I basically asked him, you know, where would he have taken Commodore? A story I have heard before, but of course people like that answer the story in a slightly different way each time they answer the question. And for those in the room that weren't aware of what was going on back in the day, it was fantastic information. David Fowler also did some of the cooking on the night, despite some issues with the oven. But yeah, a great venue. The guys are doing a stellar job just building that event up and up and up, and it just gets better each and every time. And I really appreciate it. On that note, though, so on the run-up to the night... I'd also heard, well, they mentioned in the Facebook group, there were going to be some playoffs in the middle, Link Up, Stunt Car Racer, and Lotus Turbo 2. I kid you not, another photo, plus these that you can see in the background. I practiced all week, and I didn't tell anyone I was doing this. I practiced all week. I practiced every track on Lotus 2, and I practiced every single track on Stunt Car Racer to remind myself what speed you need to take each ramp. Do you know what? I didn't play a single bout because it was just a casual thing in the middle, and I just didn't find time. I was just enjoying looking at the machines and having a good time chatting to people and getting to know even more people as you do each time you attend these events. So, you know, I don't care, no regrets. It was great. I did get a couple of pickups from the night, but that's a separate video. In all honesty, I'm waiting for a few things to arrive and then I'll put together a pickups video for you guys. On that last note, right, because I was practicing, I got to play on my Amiga on that week run-up more than I have been using it. And that's another topping in itself. And if you happen to buy Amiga Addict issue 5, because there is an article by me, I think I may have mentioned this before, even if you just buy the digital copy, you'll find my thoughts on why this sits on my desk and what it gets used for and what it means to me. But I found myself using it. So that article aside, I found myself using it more and more, getting some Stunt Car Racer practice in. I kid you not. And that was really great. So I have another person to thank, and I'll do some close-up footage in a moment. In fact, overlaid over this. But I want to thank Zach, who is a guy that I don't really even know from Adam, other than through the Discord user group chat. On the RMC channel, and he's the guy that sent me for free the SCART cable. Now, I kid you not, using this thing via SCART, I can't tell the difference in quality from this one running in emulation on this flat screen to this one running on an actual A500. It is so sharp. So really, Zach, seriously, I really do thank you. I mean, I'm lucky to find a SCART TV in Australia, in all honesty. And the reason I found that was because of the Spectrum Plus 3, which also came with an IGB to SCART cable. But I really, really do, Zach, appreciate that. That is fantastic. All right, that's all I've got for you this week, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I want to hit some gameplay videos because we've got some games stacking up now. 29 games, I think I counted. I've now got 29 Amiga games, not to mention the Spectrum games and Acorn Electron games. And that's not including the ones I'm waiting to arrive. So we're doing well. It's good. It's good. I'm happy. But more about that on the pickups video. So depending on how long things take to arrive, the next one will either be a gameplay video or it'll be a pickups video. All right. Thanks, guys. Thanks for watching.